Hello, good morning. Here Rene from Spain with a new video. And in this video, I just want to show some stuff that I bought on eBay and from Dying Victims Productions. You know, the guy Florian that made this fencing Trash Attack. I mean, I think he started with those fencings like maybe 10 years ago, and then he made more and more and more fencings. You know, number one, number two, number three. I think he went up to number 10, or I think I bought the first 9 from him, and then I just I didn't buy them anymore. But those were interesting fanzines, the Trash Attack fanzines. And also he has a kind of a label, it's Dying Victims Productions, and he released a lot of underground stuff. And also on tape too, on 7-inch singles or on vinyl, but mostly on tape. And I'm going to show some of that stuff here in this video. Yes, let's start straight away with some of the stuff I got today from Dying Victims Production. Here we have a flyer he sent to me. You see, for example, he released also the Iron Curtain Guilty as Charged on tape. Very cool. These are recent releases. Also Rotor, obscure heavy metal from Finland. And then we have also the Black Evil. Black Evil, I have the demo by Black Evil, but this is the full length album. And I also have an EP by Black Evil. Black Evil is a cool black thrash metal band, you know, Black Evil. You should check them out. Also, some of the tapes he has been releasing lately. See? One of the tapes that he released, you can see it here. It's the Vulture, the German speed metal band Vulture. You see? This is the latest album, The Guillotine, from 2017. And this came out on tape. Also, it comes with a sticker. Of course, here you got the tape. You can see the logo, Dying Victims Production. And then here we have the cover and the back cover. And this is, of course, the first full-length album by Vulture. They released also a 7-inch single this year, and last year they released an EP. I already saw them live, actually, last year, or this year. I don't remember if it was this year or last year. I think it was this year, in 2017, beginning of 2017. Vulture, from Germany. Okay, I also got this 10-inch. I also bought it from the same guy. This is the demo from 2015, I think it is, but it was recorded in 2013. But I think this 10-inch came out in 2015. See, you can see here. And this is a band, if I'm not mistaken, from New Zealand or from Australia. Oh yes, they are from Australia, because it was recorded in Melbourne, Australia. And this is like kind of a new wave of traditional heavy metal, very much influenced by the by a lot of bands from the new wave of British heavy metal. But you know, very cool. Here we have the first full-length album by Cadaveric Poison. Cadaveric Poison, and this is with Paul Speckman from Master fame. See? Sticker. Here we have the tape, green tape, looks quite nice. A little pin comes with it, and then the tape itself. It's a very old school sounding death metal. See? I mean, he was also in a band called Death Strike. I mean, maybe it's It sounds, of course, it has that sound, the Death Strike sound, but more to death metal, because Death Strike was definitely very much influenced by Venom, but this one is it's also influenced by dirty and rotten death metal from the mid and late 80s, you know. Also, don't forget Muster, the first full-length album, the official release, I think came out in 1990, but in 1985 he already recorded an album in 1985, Paul Speckman, Muster, but it was never released. You know, it was never released, the album that he recorded in 1985. But later it came out, years and years later, I think maybe in 2000, it came finally out for the first time. But yes, Muster 1985. And this reminds me of that era Muster, mixed with a lot of the dirty death metal bands like Autopsy first album, for example, and stuff like that. It's really good. Cadaveric Poison. It's got some great songs. Also, we released a 7-inch single with two songs that you also find on here. It's really a cool release. Okay, let's move on. So different styles, you know, because the guys that follow my channel, you know that I like stuff between like AOR and black metal, you know, everything in between. If it's good, if it's good written songs, and it has the right attitude, then I like it. Here we have a punk metal band, Blood Eagle. And this is the first release they did. It's a demo with three songs. Blood Eagle, the demo. Actually, I think it's one-sided only. Yes, one-sided. And here we have the inside. See, it's all handmade. See? Okay, now we're going to move on to something totally different, and this is the Stranger Thing soundtrack. You see? And it's all instrumental. This is the volume 2, and this is the volume 1. See? Two tapes. I bought this from the UK. It's not cheap, but if you like Stranger Things, I think this is a nice add to your collection. I love this series. It's really nicely done. See, it looks like a vinyl, VHS. The tapes are nice, nice color too. Nice color red. And the other one is the same, I think. Also the same color, don't remember now. No. It's just different color. The same type. See, it looks very cool and it sounds very good too. Each time when I listen to this, it takes me back to scenes of Stranger Things. It's a great, great series. You know, like 1983. It's like, it's new, of course, but it's like set in 1983. And of course, those kids were the same age in 83 that when I was a kid in 1983. You know, we were a similar age. That's why I had the same bike, I had the same walkie-talkie, a lot of the posters you see, we all had them in our rooms too. That's why this is also a nostalgic thing, you know, to watch this series. I also bought this one, Mama's Boys, Power and Passion album. I already own this on vinyl, but I bought this on tape. And this is actually a Spanish release. Yeah, I bought this just from the internet. I also got this box set from White Cross, Mega Collection. Of course, White Cross is a white Christian hard rock band. And here we have the Equilibrium album from 95, the Unveiled album from 94, and a best of, I think from 98, One More Encore. I like this a lot because, I mean, the early White Cross is great. They were more heavy metal in the early days. And later, in the early 90s, they became more, they went more into the hard rock direction. You know, that I also like. And Unveiled is a very good album, you know, from 94. A lot of people gave them up when Unveiled came out. But there's no grunge on here or nothing alternative. You know, it's not as good as the ones before, like in the Kingdom or in the albums before. High Gear from 92, for example, that was better. But here we don't have Rex Carroll on this albums. You know, the guitar player Rex Carroll in 94, he released, of course, a great album with King James. And with King James, he made that album. And the drummer was Robert Sweet from Stryper. Because in those days, in 94, Stryper was totally destroyed. I mean, there was no Stryper. Michael Sweet went solo. And Robert Sweet, and I think one more guy, I don't remember exactly, but one more guy also went into King James. And they released a great album, King James, 1994. Then later, they released one more album, The Fallen. In 95, I think it was, and it was a bad album. I bought it, and I didn't like it. But in 2013, and a lot of people don't know this, King James released an album in 2013 with the original King James vocalist. Okay? Check that album out from 2013, King James, with four re-recorded songs from the debut album by King James, but they sound a little different, plus some new tracks. Check it out, King James 2013. There's two video clips on YouTube about it. And this is a cool release. Then I also bought this soundtrack, this is a mistake actually. This is the Balls of Fury soundtrack, but I know this is the Randy Edelman composed and conducted by Randy Edelman. But there's also the same movie also has a soundtrack with songs, and also you have songs by Poison and a lot of other bands that I like. And I was gonna buy that one, but finally I made a mistake, I think, and I bought this one. But anyway, it was cheap. I didn't play it yet, it's still sealed. And then the last one I'm going to show in this video is again a release that I bought from Dying Victims production. And this is the band that I'm following from the day one. It's Armour. Armour from Finland. And they started already a little before the new wave of traditional heavy metal. You know, they played traditional heavy metal, but they were not part of the new wave because they started before. Like Metal Inquisitor. You know, they also started before. Or Wolf, or Wizard, or Majesty, all those bands started before. That's why they're not part of the new wave of traditional heavy metal. It's like Judas Priest or Motorhead for the new wave of British heavy metal. I mean, Judas Priest already released loads of records, and Motorhead was there before too. But of course, sometimes people still talk like if they were from the new wave of British heavy metal. But the new wave of British heavy metal was a movement that started in 79. And of course most of the bands released their first albums in 1980, 1981, and you know, or even 79. And those are the bands that are part of the new wave of British heavy metal. The rest are not. They were before. And the same way, the new wave of traditional heavy metal, like Ram, for example. Ram already started before the new wave of traditional heavy metal. The new wave of traditional heavy metal is a movement that started around 2010, 2011, thanks to MySpace. You know, those times MySpace was very strong, a lot stronger than Facebook, and a lot of people, like me too, we discovered a lot of new bands from all around the world. They were rehearsing, you know, and they were putting demos out and 7-inch singles out, like Armour did. Or like White Wizard did, you know, like loads of bands were doing that back then, in 2009, 2010, 2011. And this was after the new wave of thrash metal explosion that came out in 2006 and 2007. You know, with Gamma Bomb, Fooled by Fire, Warbringer. you know. And of course, a lot of people got a little tired of the thrash metal, and they went more traditional heavy metal. And all bands from all around the world, that's why it's a global. The new wave of traditional heavy metal is a global thing. You know, it's like each country in the world, even India, for example, any South American country, or in North America, we all have bands that play new wave of traditional heavy metal, and that started around that time, 2010, let's say, 2010. And those bands are part of this new wave. When is this new wave gonna end? Because officially, the new wave of British heavy metal was from 1979 to 1983. But still, bands from 84, 85, 86, they were still put in to this new wave of British heavy metal. Like, for example, Rancorsong, Samurai, even Tokyo Blade. They came out, of course, with Genghis Khan already in the early 80s, and they released the first full-length album, 83. But still, they went on and on and on. And those records, the second and third, already came out after 84. And also, yeah, there are so many bands, or Shogun, for example, the vocalist of Tokyo Blade, he formed Shogun. And of course, they are still part of the new wave of British heavy metal too. And the first full-length album came out, I think, in 84. That's why we don't know when we can stop saying, oh, that band is not part of the new wave of traditional heavy metal, even if they play traditional heavy metal. I think maybe in 2008 or 2009, we can say, no, sorry, 2019 or 2020, we can say, let's stop calling any new band that release anything after 2019 new wave of traditional heavy metal. They're not part of the new wave anymore, because listen, new wave. How can something be new when it's 10 years old? You know what I mean? I hope so you understand what I'm trying to explain in this video. Maybe it's boring. Anyway, you can switch it off if you want to. But I thought I have nothing better to do than to talk about the new wave of traditional heavy metal. Don't forget, I'm in the shop, so I have to keep looking if somebody's coming in. But nobody came in. This is great, of course. It's from 2013. This is the last 7-inch single they released till today. And this was missing in my collection. I'm happy to have it. Okay, I hope so you didn't mind this rant, you know, this conversation I had with you guys. If you want to comment anything about what I said, you can say it in the comments. I always like to talk. I always answer everybody. If once I don't answer, it's because something went wrong with the computer. Because I always answer everybody. Always. But sometimes YouTube and the messages are strange. They don't work well. Okay, this is everything I wanted to say and everything I want to show in this video. I think I will make one more video before Christmas, but I hope so you all have a great heavy metal Christmas and that you get a lot of heavy metal presents from your family and you will buy a lot of cool things for yourself. You know, because if you are into metal, you deserve all the happiness. That's what I think, you know. Of course, I'm not against other people, but I always put metalheads first, you know, like that's the way it is, you know. It's like, yeah, I don't know why, but I always have a special bond with people that like the same music as I do, you know. Anyway, stay metal, everybody.